Okay, we're gonna finish up with a little seated core work here on the mat. So come on down to your back and bring your feet in towards your seat and lift your hips, a hip bridge. Keep your hands off to the side here, or you can lift them up above you and use your shoulders to press into the mat as well as your feet. We'll hold here in a hip bridge, yes. And then lower down. And when you exhale, press the mat away from you, rise back up. We'll do a couple lifts like that. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. And then we'll pulse here for 10. So smaller pulses instead of going all the way down. 9. Squeeze your glutes at the top. 8, 7, 6. Yes, we did a few more. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lower all the way down. And then bring your legs to tabletop position. So your knees are bent here, 90 degree angle. And then bring your hands to your thighs here. And you'll lift your head and neck and press in. So your legs press back against your hands. Hands press it back into your legs. You'll feel a lot of engagement here. And there's, you know, there's kind of two different ways to do this. You can kind of effort it with some push, or you can like really go for it. Press your legs against your hands really tight. You should feel burn. Draw your lower back down toward the floor, toward the earth. And we'll hold for 10, 9, 8. 7, 6, I feel it too, I'm breathing, I'm warm. 3, 2, and 1, release. You can bring your knees in to your chest. And then we'll begin to rock up into Navasana, boat pose. Let's get back a little bit so you can see here. Lots of different ways to do boat, and Pilates is a, you could go into your full teaser. But I'm gonna hold my legs for right now, boat pose. You could have your heels down on the floor if that's where you are today. Your knees can be bent, or you could be in a full extension, and you're welcome to take your hands off of your legs too. So this is going to be where I am today. Knees are bent. Big breath in. And then lower down, but float here so your arms and shoulders are still lifted, legs are lifted, and then lift back up. Low boat to high boat. So inhale down. Exhale, lift. Inhale down. Exhale, lift. Inhale down. Exhale, lift. Let's do it over time. Inhale down, low boat. Exhale, lift. And then sink all the way down. And bring your heels back towards your seat. Like you're going into hip bridge. Instead, you're going to lift your shoulders and arms off the mat and your head, and then we'll do some oblique crunches here. So extending your fingertips as long as you can to the sides of each feet. And we'll do multiple rounds of these. So shifting side to side for 20, 18, 16, and I still count, don't worry. 10, 8, 6, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lower down. Lift your legs up to the sky. And then lower one leg down. And lift your head, neck, and shoulders. And then you'll pulse here for 2. And then switch. 1, 2. Switch. 1, 2. Switch. 1, 2. Getting a hamstring stretch and core work at the same time. So anytime you're in a core position like this and it feels like your back is rounding, your lower back can't stay on the mat, you can keep your legs higher, not drop them as low, or bend your knees for modification. That way you are starting out in the foundations of building the strength of your core through your lower back, keeping it sealed to the ground here, to the mat. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and bring your knees in. can rock yourself a little side to side. And since we did that whole core work, or if that was just the one that you did, let's take a couple stretches here and then a shavasana. So I love to be in happy baby pose if you want to do that. I kinda like can't come onto my back without doing it. So come onto your back, take your bend your knees and bring your hands to your feet. Pull your knees down toward the earth. And then release. Let's come into full shavasana pose, corpse pose. So extend out, take up space. Close your eyes. Try and breathe as free as you can, meaning letting your body just take over in the breath. And please stay here for as long as you can. Shavasana is such a gift. Soaking up what you've just done for yourself. You so often rush on to something else right after we've accomplished something or done something. Shavasana allows you to really soak in the benefits. Acknowledge yourself for doing the work. And express gratitude for everything that brought you right here. Moving on, you'll come up to a seat. Otherwise, stay in shavasana and enjoy yourself. Thank you so much for joining. Have a wonderful day.